was Glenn Close in...
Barely recognizable.
Yeah, and a terrific performance as Norma Desmond in Sunset Boulevard. Saw it twice now, once out there in Hollywood and once here, and it's just a wonderful show. Anyway, as Kathy said earlier, she won the Tony twice.
Yes.
Five-time Oscar nominee, as well as having received many Emmy and Golden Globe nominations.
I don't know how she has time to work. She's always picking up awards.
Well, I don't know how she did this, because I guess it was in between Sunset Boulevard on the Coast and its start here, because she has a terrific made-for-television movie on tonight. And here's Miss Glenn Close, everybody.
Here.
Got the shades on
today.
Yeah,
I know. I'll get my courage to take them off in a minute.
That's fine. We just saw a little bit of Norma here on stage.
Did you?
Yeah.
We had
a little clip from Sunset Boulevard.
Uh-huh.
Poor baby. I mean, what do you do, 8 shows on Broadway?
Yes.
8 shows, yes. And the last one was yesterday afternoon,
yesterday afternoon.
This is your day off.
This is my, yes.
And here you are. Well, we appreciate you
coming. Well, thank you for having me here.
I went backstage once a couple months ago, and I saw Sunset Boulevard, and I was very taken. You know, Glenn Close is a major, major star. And sometimes we in the audience, when we go see a show like that, debate in our heads, you know, should we take the time to go back? We're anxious to get home because we've got to get up early in the morning and do this every morning.
I always think that the star is anxious to go home because they've just
exactly.
exhausted themselves.
You never know what you should do in a situation like that, but I said, let's go back. I want to tell them how great it was. George Hearn, you know, and
what's Alan Campbell.
Alan Campbell is fabulous.
He's so good in it.
He's really got terrific. And then to see you, too. And so Glenn Close says to me, when everybody's gone, thanks for coming back. It means a lot to us when you do come back, you know? And so remember that.
Right.
But that was very nice. And
it means a lot to us that you're here today.
Well, thank you.
Yes, absolutely.
You must be very committed to this project, to be doing as much promotion as you are for it.
Yes, I am.
Hey, executive producer, you and Barbara.
That's right.
That's terrific.
Yeah.
Who heard about it first?
She did.
Well, it was in the news quite prominently.
Yes, that had been in the news a lot. And she heard about it and was the one person that Greta Cammermeyer was able to... She gave the story to Barbara. Barbara's able to convince her.
Mm-hmm.
It was
she
important.
Didn't want to do it.
No.
Just the way she originally didn't want to admit to being a lesbian... she's not.
Well, that's more kind of complicated. I think during the process of she was being interviewed for top secret security clearance.
But this is not a woman.
And you would think that
would
be the one point where you could really tell the truth, and it wasn't. And during the process of that interview and all the different circumstances of her life, she came to the point where she could admit to herself that she was a lesbian.
So she wanted this promotion. She wanted to be the chief nurse in charge of the entire National Guard in the country, right? And so she took this top clearance examination or whatever they call it.
Yeah, it's an interview.
But didn't she know after all these years in the service that that was the policy?
Actually, she didn't know that the policy had changed. She didn't know that just by saying you're a homosexual meant that you were out.
That had changed in, 1982 or something?
Yeah, something like that. She was unaware of that, and she was unaware of where all the people that had been thrown out had gone to. She thought, I mean, she hadn't thought about it.
Because she says that we move around a lot in the service.
Right. And then the thing that's extraordinary about her is that once they gave her a chance to recant and to go against what she had said, and that was the real watershed for her, where she said, no, I can't deny who I am.
Mm.
And that began all her... trouble.
So it was a controversial story. Did you and Barbara have difficulty selling it to the networks?
I wasn't actually in on all that part, but all I know is that ABC was tremendously behind, NBC was tremendously behind this from the very, very beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's rather unusual. I think it's the first television movie that Barbara has produced, and we had a very, very unusual team of people for a television movie. Judy Davis came all the way from Australia in order to be in it, and she's just magnificent.
Mm-hmm.
So.
You met the lady yourself, Barbara Cannon?
Yes.
She was right
on
the set, was she?
Yes, she came on the set a lot, which was wonderful for me because I didn't have the time to go to the National Guard.
And do all the research and all that.
And I just said, I need to have a very, very good military advisor, and I couldn't have had a better one in Greta.
Boy, you sure played her beautifully, though. great.
I understand the hardest scene for her to watch was the one where she tells her children, her four sons, that she is a lesbian. Was she on the set at the time that that was?
No, I don't think she could have. No, I guess, you know, for a television movie, you have to kind of change, you have to, what is the word?
Synthesize?
Make things a little bit more compact. I can't think of this early in the morning.
You don't have to worry. You look great, anyway, so that's all that matters.
In real life, she took each child, each of her four sons aside and told them each alone. In the movie, she tells them all together. The reaction basically is what was in the movie.
Yeah.
That's the surprising reaction. Mm-hmm.
One of them had trouble coping with it, and the other three kind of accepted.
We're quite supportive.
Yeah. We'll pause. We'll come right back with more from Glenn Close in a minute, and we'll show you a clip from tonight's movie.
You're giving them your full attention.
Glenn Close, who is on Sunset Boulevard on stage here in New York, besides the movie we're talking about. And just talking about this winter and all the viruses that go around.
And how demanding
everybody
this role
was affected,
is.
Including, and you caught it yourself.
Yes. Yeah. In fact, this is the best, ever since before Christmas, I've been fighting with one thing after another.
And with all that singing you do on stage, all those
and
notes.
And screaming. Yeah. Norma Desmond's a wild woman.
All right, well, let's show a clip from tonight's movie, okay? This is called Serving in Silence, Barbara Streisand, Glenn Close project.
Among others, there were about five executive producers
altogether. So in the course of this whole thing, one of Barbara's, Greta's friends trying to change, get her to change her story.
Yes, just to make her life easier, right?
And if she does, then she will probably get this post that she wants so desperately.
She'll be allowed to stay in the Army.
Yeah.
I doubt she would have gotten the post, but she probably would have left her alone, huh?
Yes, I think they would have.
All right, let's take a look at a clip now from Serving in Silence.
I was asked a direct question. I gave a direct answer. As an officer, I didn't have any choice. There wasn't any choice.
The regulation has an escape hatch built into it. Unless there is a further finding that the member is not a homosexual. What if we found that? You could have been having a midlife crisis or some sort of post-trauma syndrome or short-term mental breakdown. You could take it back, Greta.
Or can't.
You don't have to do Joan of Arc here.
If I said it wasn't true, I'd be lying.
I'm not suggesting you lie, but couldn't you have had a moment of sexual confusion and gotten over it?
No.
Fine.
I can't lie about who I am. I'd rather lose my uniform than my integrity.
And you will, you know. You're throwing away your career.
I could win.
You could commit murder and have a better chance of staying in.
And that's the reality today. Still. Although, didn't another court overturn that decision and she was reinstated into the Army?
She was reinstated, but that's being appealed by the federal government.
But today she is a practicing member of the...
She is. We had a benefit here in New York and she came in her full dressed uniform. It was fantastic.
So is she back in the service now?
Yes, she is.
Until the appeals.
Until the appeal. I mean, it's being appealed and...
How far will this go, do you think? In terms of courtrooms?
I don't know. I mean, I would hope it would eventually end up in the Supreme Court.
So her appeal was overturned.
The law has to change.
Mm. Her appeal was overturned, and now the Army has appealed.
No, she hasn't appealed. A higher court overturned the original decision, right, Glenn?
Yes.
And now it's being appealed. The Army has appealed it.
The Army's appealing.
Mm. Boy. So eventually, I think it probably will go.
And there's a lot of other people in the same position.
Yeah.
It took incredible courage for her to do what she did.
Well, it's interesting. I mean, I think it's an out. It's a law that should be changed. I mean, once blacks weren't allowed in the Army, women weren't allowed in the Army, women with families weren't allowed in the Army, and I think this is the last law that has to be changed.
I think the movie definitely makes the point. Here's a woman who had served 23 years,
with great distinction.
Yeah.
And that's why she's such a pure case of. And why she's a wonderful, she's a true hero, I think, this woman. It's very rare for somebody to stand up very simply and very quietly for their what they believe is their rights. And
Is the relationship continuing with her friend?
Absolutely, Diane. Yes.
Uh-huh. They're still together.
Yes.
Okay, well.
And that's exactly how they met? And.
Yes. I mean, I think in the movie, Judy's eating a sandwich. I think Diane was eating a toasted cheese sandwich and when they picked her up at the
artistic
bus
license.
No, they're a wonderful, wonderful pair. And it was a great privilege for me to meet them in the course of making this movie. Yeah.
Well, this controversy will go on. This will be interesting to see how the public reacts tonight to this film.
Well, I hope that people just will relate to these two women as human beings, and just because that's what attracted me to this story, besides the fact that she's an extraordinary soldier and, and I think a truly great American. This is a woman who's contending with a very difficult father with four sons, and have a lot to relate that we can relate to.
Yeah, absolutely.
After playing a soldier like that, how do you, you have a beautiful little daughter, would you prefer she go into the Army or into acting?
Oh, I don't know if she'd do well in the Army.
How about acting,
if they could contend with her?
She doesn't like to follow those orders.
Right now she wants to be an actress.
Another Glenn Close coming along.
Both are perilous.
It's on tonight at 9 o'clock on NBC, Serving in Silence. And Glenn, we thank you very, very much for getting up and being with us today.